Hello and welcome to another video tutorial. My name is Sven Goldstein and I'm product manager for our TwinCAT automation software. In this video tutorial, I would like to demonstrate how to get started with our TF6105 product, OPC UA Pub Sub, for example, to publish data via MQTT. For this, I have prepared a test environment. A test environment that consists, first of all, of the virtual machine with my TwinCAT XAE here, with my engineering, and a physical device that is attached here to this virtual machine via an ADS route, which is a CX5140. And this CX device has a couple of terminals attached to it. And I would like to publish data from one of these terminals via OPC UA Pub Sub to an MQTT message broker. So what I have prepared here is, of course, first of all, the EtherCAT configuration, which I will dive into in a short moment. And I've also prepared the OPC UA RT device. So in order to add this device, you simply need to right-click the devices node here, select add new item, and then you will find the OPC UA real-time device in the OPC UA category. And by adding this device, this will enable you to configure publishers and subscribers. So what I have prepared here is the connection to my MQTT message broker. The MQTT message broker is also located in this virtual machine, and it is pre-configured with TLS certificates, which means an MQTT client has to use a valid MQTT client certificate in order to be able to connect to this message broker. So you can do this kind of configuration on the settings tab, where you will find this MQTT configuration dialog here. And here I have already prepared the DNS name of my virtual machine instance, the port 8883, and of course the path to the certificate files, which are already located on the CX5140. So the next thing that I need to do is I need to set up my adapter settings here on the adapter tab. And with TF6105, with our OPC UA Pub Sub implementation, if you only want to use MQTT, you don't need to select an adapter reference here, because the MQTT implementation is using kernel sockets and it doesn't require our TwinCAT real-time Ethernet adapter. Only if you want to use the UDP transport, you need to specify a TwinCAT real-time Ethernet adapter here on top of this dialog. So we now want to configure a publisher on this OPC UA RT device. So we right-click the device and we select Add New Item. And in this dialog here, I can select the OPC UA publisher module. So I add this module to my configuration, and on the publisher node, you can specify different settings. So of course you can specify the transport that you would like to use. In our case, we want to use MQTT JSON, but we can also use MQTT UADP, which is a binary data format, which is more efficient than the JSON. But in our example here, we want to stay with the JSON format. You can also specify a topic on the message broker that you would like to publish the data to. You can specify a quality of service settings and many more settings that I don't want to dive into right now, because time is short for this video tutorial. And after we have configured this publisher node here, we want to add a dataset, and the dataset will contain the variables that we would like to transport. So I right-click the publisher node, I select Add New Item, and I then have the option to configure two different kinds of datasets. So the first one is a dataset without variables, which means that you can add variables, for example, via the target browser. And the second one is a dataset with variables, and this dataset will then contain all the variables on the process image here, of the IO device, and then you need to do a link to, for example, PLC variables. So, but we will stay with the first option, a publisher dataset without variables. And as I have mentioned before, I would like to transport data from my EtherCAT master, so from one of the terminals, right? So I open the settings of the dataset here. I go to the dataset fields, and this is the list that I want to populate now with variables from my EtherCAT master. So I switch to the target browser, and I can now browse to the ADS server of the EtherCAT master. And in order for that to work, you need to activate something on the EtherCAT master. So on the image node of the EtherCAT master, you will find a tab called ADS. And on this tab, you need to enable, first of all, the ADS server. And then you also need to enable this create symbols option here. And this will create symbolic information for all the nodes on the EtherCAT master, for the terminal, for the different channels below the terminal, and of course for every individual variable below that channel too. Okay, so I'm switching back to my data set fields now, and I now simply drag and drop this EL3318 to my data set fields. And now what the OPC UA PubSub implementation does, it creates structured types for all the channels below the EL3318. And we will later see what that actually means. So this is the configuration that I want to publish now to the MQTT message broker. And yeah, I just activate this configuration. And when it asks me to restart TwinCAT, of course I want to do that. I want to activate this configuration now and switch TwinCAT into run mode. And after that, I can now connect any MQTT client to the message broker and actually see the data. So for this, I would like to use an internal tool, but you can use, like I said, any MQTT client. But we have an internal tool called the MQTT browser. And on this MQTT browser, which is already connected to my local message broker, I can now find the topic that I specified in my PubSub configuration. And here I will find the data that is being published by my OPC UA PubSub driver. And this is what I meant when I said, hey, the PubSub, our PubSub implementation is creating structures for the different channels of the terminal, which means you will find this structure information here in the JSON payload and all the information coming from the terminal on the EtherCAT master. Yeah, so that was about it. There is not much magic behind it. I mean, most of the configuration is being done on the UI, so you don't really have to program anything. It's just a drag and drop. It's just drag and drop operations and a couple of settings. But yeah, now you have successfully configured OPC UA PubSub to publish data from an EtherCAT master to an MQTT message broker. And I hope that this information was useful for you. And see you on the next tutorial. Thank you very much for listening. Have a great day. Bye.